Hello everybody, it's John. Welcome to my side of a two-car garage here in Texas, and this is the second of a series about installing a DRO on a little Grizzly G704 milling machine. I did a box opening before. The DRO that I got was from Amazon, and it was a relatively inexpensive DRO. I talked about why I chose this one in the first video. Also, the first video showed when I opened the box opening, I thought the scales were too long, and they actually were. I was real disappointed in that, but I went online and people said you could not adjust those glass scales. Some said you could, most people said you couldn't. Well, I had nothing to lose, and I actually shortened those glass scales, and I put a video of it. I actually cut those glass scales on a metal cutting bandsaw. They work perfectly, and I'll link to that video below if you're curious about cutting those glass DRO scales. What I did for this install, instead of having the camera running all the way through, I just got my phone and just snapped a few pictures along the way. They're just still shots. I believe they'll be pretty self-explanatory and maybe answer some questions that I had about how to mount different things. On the G704 mill, the base is actually slanted at an angle, and if it was up at a 90 degree, it would be much easier to install. But that angle really throws things kind of havoc. Or throws havoc into things, so you'll have to make some decisions along the way. You know, do you mount it vertically, horizontally, or at an angle? A lot of choices, and you'll see what I did. You'll see a way that I started and then a way that I ended up doing. At the end of the day, everything works out really well. So 15 or 20 shots right here to give you some ideas, and then we'll come back and we'll wrap it up. I've got a few pictures that I took along the way as I installed the DRO that may be helpful. I just took these more or less at random to sort of sequence the way that I did it. I'm sure you'll find a better or perhaps a different way to do it, and I'm sure a better way. The first thing I did was go ahead and remove the crank wheel on the left-hand side. That was very easy to do. It was just a 13 millimeter nut on it. It did have a little small spring in there. You want to be sure that you don't let that fly off. It wasn't under any tension or anything. Also, there was a small keyway in there. I just went ahead and took that out so that I would not lose it. So that's the first thing. The next thing I did was go ahead and take some masking tape. And I put some masking tape, and I just used two colors here for the picture. The bottom part where the white masking tape is, that is actually just the size of the scale at the bottom. The little hashtags at the end are where the end of the DRO will go. That's where the mounting bracket, or that's where the screws actually mount the DRO scale. And the blue at top is relative to the size of the reader. So what I'm doing right here is just essentially getting my front and my rear travel so I'll know where to mount the DRO and actually screw the screws or tap the holes for it. And then the next thing I did was just run the table all the way to the front to get the y-axis, and then I marked that. That's what that F is with that line right there. And then I did the same thing in the back, ran it all the way back as far as I could go, and then that was the rear of the travel. And that let me know, because of the hashtags, that's the end of the DRO, so I've got plenty of room left over, and that gives me a travel of the length of that arrow, which is full travel for the little G0704. Next thing I had to do was think about mounting the scale. And the first thing you have to consider is on those gibs, there's not a lot of metal down there to work with. So the black line is giving an indication of about where I'm going to put the screw in. In reality, it was more towards the half, but when I made the mark on it, I was a little off center on that. But I tried to get as close to halfway as possible. Now, this is the first thing that I tried, and this would have been the method that I would have preferred. I built a bracket, and I put that bracket at the same angle as the side piece. And this was my intention, was to go ahead and mount the reader and the scale itself at the same angle that was on the mill. However, that just turned out to be too big of a job, and I didn't want to try to do that. So this is what I ended up with. I actually ended up, instead of the scale being mounted vertically or at an angle, I mounted everything horizontally. So this is the way it finally ended up. So here's how I did that. The first thing I did, and this piece right here was actually, I just milled this down. There were a lot of brackets that came with this mill that really just didn't make any sense at all. There was fasteners that didn't fit anything. It was almost like they had swept the floor and just threw some parts in the bag. But the threads, nothing really matched but about 4 metric screws in the whole thing, so I did have to go buy some extra screws. But what I did is milled the angle iron down, and then I took the angle iron to the grinder, because I'm going to show you in a minute that that corner of that is going to have to be ground off just slightly. Because when I put it on the machine, as you can see here, I wanted it to have enough top part there for the Allen screws or the socket head screws to go ahead and mount up. And that would have made it drag on the bottom. So again, what I did, I just took the corner off of that little piece of angle iron. Now, we ended up, this is the way that it mounted, and you can see up here at the top, it's a little out of focus, but due to the depth of field in this picture, but you can see the top part up there is where the reader is attached. And what I did is used just some cold rolled steel, and I made some standoffs, and I drilled a 10-24 hole into the cast iron base, and then I mounted the DRO more of a horizontal than any other way. This is a side picture of what I did, and here you can see the reader that is attached, and this will give you just a straightforward view of how I did the Y-axis. It actually turned out, after a lot of trouble, to be a relatively neat installation, so I'm pretty happy with that. I will be putting a cover on it. I just haven't figured out exactly how to do that. The covers that came with it are not going to be able to be used, so I'll probably end up putting some kind of a vinyl or leather. Now for the X-axis, I didn't get as many pictures as I probably should have, but it kept being, well, that's pretty self-explanatory, so I won't take a picture. But what I did, I just undid the rubber wiper that's on the back, and everything here, there were no new holes that needed to be drilled back here. Everything here was just actually modified to go right back into the hole of where that bracket was that holds this rubber wiper or chip guard on. So I've got just some standoffs here holding off a piece of 1/4-inch aluminum. And that's what that vertical part is. And as you can see, that red part right there, that is the reader that is mounted steady. And the scale itself slides here, where on the Y-axis, the reader was steady, or the scale was steady, and the reader moved. This is another case right here where I've just got the table all the way moved off to one side, and you can just see how the bottom part is just attached to the table itself, and the top part is just screwed in with some 10-24 screws. It has no standoffs or anything on it. And again, this is just more of a close-up of what the centerpiece is, and this is the reader that never moves, and all of these screws that you see there are going right back into the holes where that little black strip was that holds the rubber wiper on. And again, this is just a close-up shot of the 1/4-inch standoff that the reader is mounted to. Now, one thing that I was not able to do right now, I'm going to go back and do. I've just got the wiper that's just resting on the X or the Y travel that's in the back. And it's still a pretty good chip guard, but as you can see, it actually, some chips can actually run down the front side of that chip guard and get down in there. So I need to fix that. It's not urgent that I do. And what I'll do is just go back and not drill any new holes. I'll just attach it to the bolts that are already there. When it all finally ended up, this is how it attached to the side. There were only two of those little cable clamps that came through it. I'll need to get some more of those. But at the end of the day, it ended up being a pretty good install. Well, that's the install process that I went through. And I got to tell you, it was not as easy as I thought it was going to be. It was not difficult. One of the things that I did, I really overanalyzed everything. I overanalyzed the mounting, and I can't tell you how many times I started the process, especially on the Y-axis. That's the one I did first, and because it was the most difficult, I wanted to get it out of the way. And I made brackets one after the other. I never was really satisfied with the way it worked out. Working all those angles out and so forth, it was a hassle. At the end of the day, to me, the horizontal was the best way to do it. Now, I do know that Grizzly sells this machine with a glass scale DR on it. In fact, I've been in their showroom. And I sure wish I had taken some pictures of the way they did it, because as I recall, they mounted that DRO vertically. When I go back up, and I go up there about two or three times a year, I'm going to look at that and just see how they did it. I may come back and change this one. But as I said, at the end of the day, this was about a 2 full-day project. Probably wouldn't have taken that long if I had taken out my start stops. So my suggestion is just go in head first, find a way to mount the thing, and just keep moving forward. Don't overanalyze a lot of stuff. As you saw in the video, the rubber chip guard in the back, I've still not completed that, and I've got a few other things to do. There was more than once in there, though, I thought, gee, I wish I'd have just gotten those little smaller eye gauge units. But again, it's just that backlit DRO that I really was wanting really bad. I'll show you that it's working on the machine, and then we're going to close this thing out. Here I'm just zooming in on the digital display, and it is a pretty clear display on it, and I'm just going to turn the X and Y axis so that you can see that it's moving here. It does clear out really well. You can clear the X and the Y axis out. It does have the circle bolt hole calculator. It actually has almost anything any other DRO has. This is just a more of a pan view of the Y axis in case you have any questions about the view of it. Well, that's it from one side of a two-car garage in the great state of Texas. This is John. We'll catch you in the shop on the next video.